Good morning, children. How are you all? So happy to see you in another lesson. And today we are going to see a beautiful topic and very interesting topic. Everybody knows this. Yes or no? See, everybody likes to know about forest. So today we are going to see about forest. Okay. So what is called forest? First of all, we will understand what is forest. See, a large area. See, for example, a large area filled with many trees is called forest. Okay. See, forest means it's a large area of land and it is thickly covered with trees and having rich natural environment. Okay. So in this lesson, Sita is going to take you around the forest. So she is introducing each and every trees and the uses of that tree. So today we are going to see about that. See, have you seen a forest? What do you see in the forest? Yes, you see wild animals, snakes, monkeys, elephants, lion. Yes or no? So you see many animals in the forest. See, forest grow in almost every part of the world. Okay. So see, there are many trees also. Animals, for their survival, for their living, they choose the forest. Okay. See how we choose residential areas. We build house where our neighbors are there. Okay. Like that, they live in the forest. Okay. So what they are telling us is, what are the animals they live in the forest? Fruits, vegetables, trees, like that. See, there are two basic types of trees. Okay, in the forest, first of all, we will see two types of trees. One is hardwoods and softwoods. So many forest contains either hardwoods or softwood. So, but some forest have both types. See, we can see many different types of trees, hardwood trees. They are very big leaves and they grow big. Okay, and even they give some fruits, vegetables according to the temperature they grow. Okay. See, sometimes softwoods also very useful, and it will grow near the mountains and rainy forest. Okay. So in forest, every forest is a complex living system made up of thickly growing, see, trees, bushes, fungi and other plants. Okay. So forests are also the homes of mammals, birds and insects and any other animals. Okay. Different types of trees. Okay. So as the forest ages or change, it affects all the living things in it. See, these mammals, birds, they live in, some live on trees, some live on land. Yes or no? They give fruits. So these living things all depend on each other to survive. Is that clear? So each and every living being is depending on each other. Many important natural resources come from the world's forests. See, what are they giving? They give food, wood, fuel, natural fibers and many other materials. See, these resources are made, maybe made into furniture, shelter. So we have seen this slide. No, there are like shelter, many things. See, furnitures, grains, foods, clothes, medicinal things, many like this. Even instruments, musical instruments. See, medicines and many other products they are giving. Yes or no? And also one more important thing is, forests are known as the lungs of the planet. This is because they supply huge amount of earth's oxygen, which animals need to breathe. Okay, see, to save natural forest, people sometimes plant tree farms as workers cut down the trees grown on these farms. They plant new trees to replace them. Okay, see, forest trees are also help to protect soil from soil erosion, and they block the forces of wind and water that wear away the land. So we can explore many things in the forest, and forest also helps us in many ways. See, like this, in our book, in page number 28, they have asked two examples for each tree. See, the teak wood tree. Can you see the teak wood tree? See, it is very, very useful to us. Very, very useful to us. So, this teak wood helps us in furnitures. We have seen teak wood cuttle, teak wood sofa set, like that. Okay. See, the sandalwood. What the sandalwood do? We have this Mysore sandal soap, cream, face cream, scent. Yes or no? We have this perfumes, all this. So, these are very useful. Then comes the jambu tree. Jambu tree, see, this also very useful to us. How they are helping us. With this, we make salads, sauce, like this. Okay, next is the banyan tree. Banyan tree is the biggest tree. Yes or no? It grows very big. See, it provides fresh air. It provides fresh air, and mostly it gives a shade to everybody. And moreover, in banyan tree you can see many animals like monkeys and birds. They live in the banyan tree. Okay, so it provides food for other organisms. And also we can see this pongamai, this tree. This also very useful. This also gives us shade, and also it is used for many medicinal things. Okay, next, neem tree. Everybody knows about this neem tree. This also helps us in many ways. Sometimes if we go to the village, all the old village people, they will brush the teeth. Yes or no? With this stick, they will brush the teeth. Sometimes for stomach upset, all like that, they chew these leaves. Yes or no? And also we have soaps. Neem soap, like that. Okay, next, gooseberry. Gooseberry is very, very useful for us, and it is very delicious fruit, and we can eat it. We see it all over our places nearby. Yes or no? Okay, next, the bamboo tree. Bamboo tree is also very useful. It is used for food, and bamboo sticks are used for windows. It is also used for gardening, like that. Okay, see, what happens if we cut down the tree? So now, till now, you can understand what this tree is. Okay, what is the forest, what is the uses of the forest. See, for thousands of years people have been cutting down forest for wood and to make room for farms and cities. Now many of the world's forests are in danger of disappearing. Okay, so these many people work to protect the forest. For instance, say for example, this Chipko movement in India, see, it was started in to protect the destruction of forest. So people, mostly women from small villages, would form a circle around the trees to prevent them from being cut down. Okay, so forestry is the science of managing forest. People who work in forestry study the life cycles of trees and other forest plants. They also work to prevent the spread of tree disease, and they keep trees safe from harmful insects and control forest fire. So to save the forest, many governments also create national forest, state parks, and wilderness preserves. In these places, forests are left in their natural state for people to enjoy. See, what happens if we cut the forest trees? What happens to it? What happens? Yeah, we will have the change in climate. We will have the climate change. If we destroy the forest, our nature will be destroyed. Our natural will be destroyed. Then the animals which lives in the forest will also come outside. Yes or no? If their house is destroyed, where they will go? They will come outside. Yes or no? Come outside from the forest and they will start to live in our place. Okay, so if we cut down the trees, the birds will get disturbed. There is no place for them to live, and the water will get polluted. All the animals will be disturbed. Okay, so what do you understand? What do you understand? What is a forest? Forest is a place where there is thickly grown trees are seen. Okay, and forest means all the wild animals will be there. Okay, so this is just for your understanding. So what are the five plants that grow generally in forest? What are the trees we have seen? Big trees, oak tree, maple tree, different types of trees. Okay, then what are the animals that live in forest? Yes, yeah, very good. Chimpanzee, lion, tiger, snake. Okay, name five fruits that are available in forest. What are the fruits? We have already seen some fruits. What are they? They are star fruits. Have you seen that fruits which I have already shown you? Star fruit, wood apple, jackfruit, blueberries. And what are the uses of forest? Can you tell me what are the uses of forest? See, what are the uses? It gives us fruits and vegetables. It gives us food. First main thing is it gives us food. It gives us shelter. It gives us wood for our house to make the furnitures. And it gives us paper. It is used in cooking. Medicinal products are got from the forest. And many musical instruments you can make. Wooden toys you can make. Okay, many rubber things also you can make. Okay, so this is what we have to understand. So we should not destroy our nature. So trees add beauty to nature. So lot of greenery and fruits, they give air, water, food and energy. So this is what we get from trees, and trees are nature boon to us. Okay, so no land without forest, no fruits without trees. Okay, this is not the life. So we can't live without the trees and animals and this environment. Okay, so what you have to do is you collect the pictures of trees from the newspapers, books, magazine, and you paste them in your notebook, and then collect information about that. Okay, write what are the pictures you have collected, write the names of that trees, and then what is the use of that, you write it down. Is that clear? That will be your activity. Okay, children, thank you so much.